In last lecture, we have studied how to separate the substance which are in the solid form. Now, mixture we have studied last time. The mixture is the combination of two substances without chemical reaction. Means the mixture is formed by taking the two different substances without any chemical reaction. That we call as mixture. Then, in the last lecture, we have studied how to separate the solid from the mixture. The methods we have studied, that is harvest, winnowing, harvesting, threshing, hand picking, that all are useful for separating the solid substance. Now we'll see magnetic method. Magnetic method is also useful to separate the solid substance, but if we have mixture of the iron nails and sulfur powder, if you have the mixture of iron nails and sulfur powder, then if we can, by using the magnet, we can remove the iron nails, as magnet attracts the iron nails. Magnet attracts the iron nails when we move the magnet through this mixture. So magnet will attract the iron nails. Iron nails will stick to that, and the sulfur powder will remain in the bowl, or we can separate the iron nails from the mixture. But for this method, the substance should be the magnetic. The magnetic substance means the substance which is getting attracted toward the magnet is called as magnetic substance. So where the magnet substance is there in this mixture, if we use the magnetic method, then we can remove the magnetic material from that, and other part will remain in that mixture. So in this way we can use the magnetic method. Now in the mines, the iron is separated. In the mines, iron is separated from the remaining unwanted substances by using the magnet. The iron will attract toward the magnet, and which is unwanted substance, that will remain in the mine. So in the mine, to separate the ions, the magnetic method is also useful. Now this is the second use of this magnetic method. Now the recyclable iron paste, this we can separate from the in the junkyard. You are knowing that iron waste is there, we can recycle well it. So recycled iron waste we can separate from the other thing in the junkyard by using the magnet. Magnet will attract this recycled iron, and we can remove from this junkyard by using the magnet. So these are the different methods by which we can remove the magnets from that. The doctor used the magnet. Doctor used the magnet to remove small iron particles which are enter in our eye. Doctors use magnet to remove the small iron particles in the eye. When they move the magnet, the iron particles will get attracted towards magnet, and that can be removed from that. If the person get injury, and if the splinters are, means iron particles or ions are embedded into the body, then that magnetic material or that magnetic substance, means iron substance, can be removed by using the magnet from the patient's body. So doctor also used to magnet to remove the iron particles from eye and from the body of the injured person. So in this way we can use the magnetic method also. This is also useful for solid substance to separate. So all these which we have studied, these are the methods to separate the solid particles from the mixture. Now most of you knowing that milk is healthy drink. Milk is healthy drink. So every one of you are drinking the milk up to 14-15 years. In this milk, milk contain calcium, then proteins and fats. But this too much fats, if the fats are more, the fats quantity is more in the milk. So we have to separate the fats in the milk. It contains calcium, proteins and fats, but too much fats is not healthier for our body. So we have to remove the fats from, or we have to separate the fats from the milk. So after removing the fats, or after separating the fats from the milk which is formed, that is called as low fat milk, or it is called as skimmed milk. So to remove the fats, we are using the separating methods, and after separating the fats which is more into the milk, that we separate, then the milk from is called as low fat milk or skimmed milk, that is useful for our body. So in this way we can use the different methods to separate the solid substance from the given mixture. Now we see the if the solid is dissolved in the water, then what we have to do. So now we see the next method, that is sedimentation. The next method of separation is sedimentation. Now this method is useful for liquid. In the liquid, if heavy insoluble particles are there, in the liquid, if heavy insoluble particles are there, then by sedimentation means we have to keep this liquid in the beaker. This is the liquid which is kept in that glass, and in that heavy insoluble particles are there. So if we keep this glass or beaker for some time, then all the heavy particles, they will settle at the bottom. Heavy particles will settle at the bottom, and you will get the clear water up. Means what are the impurities or what are the insoluble particles in the liquid? If we keep in the glass or beaker for some time without disturbing, then all these heavy particles will settle at the bottom. And this process, settling of these heavy insoluble particles at the bottom of liquid, is called as sedimentation. So sedimentation is nothing but the heavy insoluble particles will settle down at the bottom of the glass or bottom of the pot. And this method is called as sedimentation. And these particles which we constitute or which we form, that is called as sediments. Sediments is nothing but it is the heavy insoluble particles in the liquid. So this method of separating the heavy insoluble particles in the liquid is called as sedimentation. That all particles will settle at the bottom, and that is called as sedimentation. So this is the first method, that is called as sedimentation. Last year also we have studied this. Now second is as we are getting the beaker which contains the sediments at the bottom. We are getting the sediments at the bottom, and here at the top you are getting the clear water. We are getting, after sedimentation, you are getting the clear water up, and sediments are settled down at the bottom. Now this clear water, if we pour without disturbing the sediments, if the clear water is poured into the other jar or other beaker, if we pour this clear water without disturbing the heavy soluble particles, insoluble particles into the other jar. So we can get, we have separated these sediments from this liquid. So this method to pouring the clear water without disturbing the sediment, this method is called as decantation. Means we have separated the sediment from the liquid and we have poured into the other jar or other vessel or other glass. This pouring of this clear water into the other jar without disturbing the sediments is called as decantation. And first is sedimentation, where the insoluble heavy solid particles are settled down at the bottom of the pot. So this is sedimentation, and second process is decantation. Now we have separated the heavy insoluble particles in the liquid. Now still, this clear water which we are getting after decantation, this clear water which we are getting after decantation, it contains the suspended insoluble particles. This clear water which we are getting from the decantation process, it contains the suspended insoluble particles. Now how to remove these insuspended particles from this clear water? That method is called as filtration. To remove the suspended insoluble particles from the clear water, that method is called as filtration. So now we see what is filtration. This filtration means you are knowing the funnel. In your many times you have seen the funnel. So this funnel is used for filtration method. The filter paper is there in the laboratory, that you have to make the shape of like this filter paper, and you have to put the filter paper in the funnel, and you have to put the funnel on this beaker. And which is the clear water that you have to pour through this funnel which contains the filter paper. This funnel contains the filter paper, and that filter paper we have put into that funnel. So when we pour this clear water, the suspended particles will get retained on this filter paper, and the water will comes down to this clear water, which is your got clear water. So now we have separated the heavy insoluble particles, then suspended particles from the water. So we are getting the here clear water. So suspended particles in the water is separated from the filtration. This particle will retain on this filter paper. That particle retained on the filter paper is called as residue. The suspended particles which we are getting on this filter paper and water will collected in the gas, means in the beaker. So that particles which are collected, which is suspended in the water, that is called as residue, and the water which we are getting down, that is called as filtrate. That is called as filtrate. So in the filtration process, after decantation, clear water will pour in the diesel funnel containing the filter paper. So suspended particles will retain, or it will collected on this filter paper, and the clear water will comes down in the beaker. So the suspended particles which retain on the filter paper, that is called as residue, and the clear water which are getting down, that is called as filtrate. So this is called as filtration process. So this process, that is sedimentation, then decantation, and filtration. These processes are useful to separate the heavy insoluble particles in the liquid. So these are all three processes, that is sedimentation, decantation and filtration. These processes are used to separate the particles which are not dissolved in the water or in the liquid. For that we are using this the method. So now we study next, if the particles are dissolved in the water or liquid, then which type of methods we have to use, that we have to see. Now third point is, particles are dissolved in the liquid. Now particles are dissolved in the liquid, then how we will separate these particles from this liquid? The just now which we have seen, in that the particles are not dissolved in the liquid, so that process are decantation, sedimentation and filtration. But now the particles are dissolved in the liquid, now how to separate that we see. Now suppose you have mixture of salt plus water. If you are getting this mixture of salt and water, and if you keep this mixture in the sunlight, or you are going salt is dissolved in the water, so we cannot see. And now we have to remove the salt from water. So this mixture, if we keep in the sunlight, because of the heat of sunlight or because of the heat of the sun rays, the water will get evaporated. And after some times you will get the salt in the beaker or in the pot. Means salt and water, in which the salt is dissolved in the water, that can be separated by keeping in the sunlight. Because of heat, the water get evaporated and the salt will remain in this. So in this way we have separated the dissolved substance in the water. So this method is called as evaporation. This separating the from the mixture of salt and water, to separate the salt, is called, this method is called as evaporation. So what is evaporation? The liquid is converted into the vapor state or gaseous state. When the liquid is converted into the vapor state, that process is called as evaporation. So by using the evaporation process, we can get the salt from the seawater. And in this evaporation method is used to get the substance which is dissolved in the water. So this is the called as evaporation. Evaporation means the conversion of liquid into gaseous state or in the vapor state, that is called as the evaporation. So this evaporation method is useful to get the salt from seawater. Now next we'll see. I will tell you one simple experiment that all of you have observed many times. Suppose you have the glass of, if you've taken the glass of water and put some ice cubes in it, there is the glass of water and that some ice cubes are put in this. So after some times, if you observe on the surface of this glass, you can see the water droplets are formed. This, the how this happens, the ice cube, or instead of ice cube, you can take the water from the refrigerator, which is very cold, and if you keep in the stainless steel glass, then after some times you can see the water droplets on the surface of this, as there is the water in the atmosphere. There are water vapor in the atmosphere. As this water vapor comes in contact with the cold surface of the glass, ice cubes are very cold, So when this water vapor comes in contact with the surface of glass or this stainless steel glass, then this water vapor converted into the water. All of you have observed this many times phenomena. When you are keeping the very cold water into the stainless steel glass, you can see afterwards the small water droplets on the surface of this glass. This is because water vapor comes in contact with this surface and it changes into the water. Means here the water vapor, means gaseous state, is converted into the water. So this process is called as condensation. The conversion of water vapor into water, this process is called as condensation. So this is the example of condensation. And conversion of water into gaseous state, this process is called as evaporation. This process is called as evaporation. Conversion of water vapor into water is called as condensation. And conversion of water into gaseous state is called as evaporation. So these are opposite natures of each other, which is useful to separate the substance which are dissolved in the liquid. So in short, we can say that the liquid is converted into the gases, that is evaporation process, and liquid is vapor is converted, or gases is converted into the liquid, that is called as condensation. So by using this method, evaporation and condensation, we can separate the substance which is dissolved in the liquid. So these are the two methods which we have used for separating the substance which is dissolved in the water. So once again I will repeat that this conversion of liquid to gaseous state and gaseous state to liquid, this liquid to gaseous state, that is called as evaporation, and gaseous to liquid state, that is called as condensation. So this evaporation and condensation, these are the two processes. These two processes are used in United Arab Emirates. This is the Saudi Arabia country, United Arab Emirates. In this, where these two methods are used to get the salt from seawater. So seawater has the salt. So by evaporation method, the salt is getting from seawater, and then the after evaporation, the evaporated water, evaporated liquid is converted. The evaporated means in United Arab Emirates, salt is getting from seawater by using these two methods, evaporations and condensation. And the condensation means after this process, means evaporation process, the water vapor will form. So water vapor is condensed for to get the liquid or to get the water or drinking water, because they have scarcity of drinking water. So in United Arab Emirates, from seawater, by using the evaporation process, they are getting the salt. And as the vapor, this vapor is condensed. Condensed means it is converted from vapor to liquid state, and they are getting the water. So by using the condensation process in United Arab Emirates, they are getting the drinking water, and by evaporation process, they are getting the salt from seawater. So in this way, these two methods are useful to separate the substance which is dissolved in the liquid. So we have studied now today the three methods in which in one method there is the solid is divided, dissolved into liquid. In liquid. And in other method, solid is not dissolved in the liquid. So for these two processes, we have different methods. When the solid is dissolved in the liquid, we have the process which is evaporation and condensation. And when the solid is not dissolved in the liquid, we have the process which are sedimentation, then decantation and filtration. So all these methods are useful to separate the solid from the liquid, where the evaporation and condensation methods used for separating the solid which is dissolved, and sedimentation, decantation, filtration is used for when solid is not dissolved in the liquid. By using the evaporation process, you can get the salt from seawater, and after gas is mixed, after water vapor is converted into the liquid, by you are getting the clean drinking water in the United States. The process is called as condensation. So in this way, we have studied the separation of substance in which liquid part we have studied today. Thank you.